Resistance.
We are also learning that there is going to be a protest.
A protest. Going to be a protest.
Resistant to Silence is a platform created to stand up against corrupt law enforcement entities by exercising our First Amendment rights as Americans. We are here to spread information about standouts, protests, and gatherings, and offer a safe place for discussion.
Now you do what they told you. Now you do what they told you.
what they told you. I can run the control. Now I can do what they told you. I can run the control. Now I can do what they told you. I can run the control. And I can do what they told you. I can run the control. And I can do what they told you. I can run the control. And I can do what they told you. I can run the control. And I can do what they told you. I can run the control. And I can do what they told you. Don't you guys are justified for wearing your badge and your chosen white? You're justified. Those that died for wearing the badge and your chosen white. Those who died are justified for wearing the badge and your chosen white. You're justified. Those that died for wearing the badge and your chosen white. Come on.
What up?
Yeah.
Hey. I was fired up.
I wish people could see us backstage because I could see Tracy. And I don't even want the show to start. I just want to listen to some tunes.
You know, and I've been listening to that song all day long because I was making that video. And it was actually the past 2 days. So I've been like banging my head. Can't get
I love
of
being
head.
Surprised.
That was the first one I was surprised. I was usually seeing them all. That was going.
Yeah,
that
I have to awesome. Finish it this yeah. afternoon. So
that was good. What's up, everybody?
Happy hey, everyone. Wednesday. What's going on? Sorry. Go ahead. All right, you guys.
All start. Right. Very good. Big.
What was that? We're
both like.
And yeah. Okay.
Anyway,
no. This is a big week, man. Big week.
I got to admit to everybody, though, up front, that I'm flying by the seat of my pants tonight. I've been a little bit busy, a little bit crazy, so we're going with the flow tonight, man.
Why don't you just give the people a little idea of what the next couple of days is going to be like for you?
You're flying by the seat of your pants. I'm not
yeah, you.
Well, let me see. I just got home a half hour ago. After I get done with this, I got to do laundry. Not that anyone really cares. Then get up at four in the morning, go to work, then go to court, then go back to work, then come home tomorrow night and pack, and then Friday morning, I'm out of here.
Yeah.
So to say,
it's been a crazy couple days.
Yeah, he's pretty stressed out. So he is just flying by the seat.
It's all worth it though.
It is worth it for sure.
It's been a crazy, crazy past few weeks. Shit, past year. Let's say that.
I know, right?
Yeah, I think, you know, I mean, we just kind of get right after it. I don't know what you want to say about Aiden. I know Aiden has a date coming up on the 23rd, Paul. You want to talk about that real quick?
I mean, I don't have the time yet, and it's April 23rd. Seems like a long ways away. It's not that long away.
It's not.
The times changes. Times seem to change with this courthouse. This is at Norfolk Superior.
Yeah.
It's not as of now. I believe it's 9 o'clock, but things change as we get closer. So he might have a court date prior to then. We'll just leave it at that.
Yeah.
It's not set in stone yet. So once he does that, I'm sure he'll let us all know. That's his next thing on the Aiden front. So I'm hoping, who knows, maybe he won't have to go to court.
Yeah, right.
You know, see what happens.
Yeah, next exactly. Week.
You know, well, so
things are happening, things are moving, you know. Unfortunately for the Canton Nine, they're still not yet. But again, you know, this week and this new motion, maybe could change quite a bit. Who knows?
Yeah, well, yeah. I think the Canton Nine are just sort of hanging out in limbo till everything else is done.
Yeah.
Collateral damage.
Yeah.
It's
is what I say. Michelle's putting in 2:00 in the chat, so maybe
Yeah, I just saw that. So maybe it is two.
And then someone asked me if I have tan in the can. That is me.
He's getting ready for vacation. You know, he's getting a tan.
Yep.
Those Italian guys.
But
you got your Speedo ready? Or?
Oh, you'll get some pictures, Dana, just for you, honey.
We'll make it our new logo.
Oh yeah, no, not you don't want to. We're trying to attract viewers, not get them away.
Yeah, how to lose viewers in one day.
Oh my god. Hey, but I wanna just real quick, I wanna say hi to Mike Bradford. Hey buddy, we miss you.
Hey, there he is. I saw Mike the other day. He was out holding signs on Saturday.
Nice. How you doing, Mike? Nice.
And I gotta give a special thank you to Mike Bradford, and he knows why. Okay. I'm just gonna leave it at that. He hooked me up.
All right.
Excellent. Outstanding. Good people.
Yep.
I had only talked to Mike maybe twice, three times ever. Great guy, Mike. We get you back.
Yep. And we miss you.
Yep.
There we go. Scott McGinnis. Look at this. There we go.
Well, no, we can't reach Speedos.
Scott, get on that. Yeah, you make those. You just easily.
Yep.
Wrap those up, get them out there. I'm sure Paul will model it.
I'll do anything.
Anything to support the cause, Paul.
Yeah.
Whatever it takes.
Free Karen Reed Speedo Men's Speedo Calendar.
Ew.
The men of the movement.
Our viewership just dropped by 50%.
I know.
people are like, I just ate dinner. I'm sick now.
Hey, guys, listen, if you're new to the channel and new checking us out, first of all, everyone hit the like button, subscribe button, please get us going. But if you're new to the channel, this is what we do. We're not here for legal stuff. We'll talk a little bit about it, but look where we're both sitting. Tracy's and Dana in their living room. We're in our living room. We're just people hanging out and inviting you guys to hang out. We'll talk about some good stuff, what we're going to be doing, what we did last week, what we did this week. And what we're doing this week, tomorrow's a big one, but I probably think we should start from the last week. Last protest.
Go back in time. What did we do? Monday we did something, didn't we?
Oh yeah, we did a little thing on Monday.
That was amazing. Monday. So we went to meet Paul Morrissey's office on Monday at 3 to let him know that we were not pleased with this new motion, and the turnout was amazing.
It was.
Go ahead. You had a lot of that day.
We've been there a few times, and I firmly believe this past Monday was probably our best showing, our best representation. The attitude was fantastic. We had press there. It was everything. The march around was great, and when we told you guys before, we heard from the last time we did the march around that we have some friendlies in there, and they told us. We were definitely heard, and I'm sure we were heard the other day. And actually, one of the news channels got a response from Morrissey, which was kind of dumb. Response from his office about the whole 500-foot buffer thing. It was funny if you didn't see the response. It was basically like they didn't submit it. The response was, well, it's up to the judge what she wants to do. No, you submitted it, Morrissey.
Yeah, right. Exactly.
Your office submitted it.
Yep. Unbelievable.
Yeah. I like it's Scott McGinnis. I like this. We brought Noah's Ark of animals for meatballs.
I know. There were a lot of dogs there the other day. It was great. No, Nathan had a lot of support. It was good.
Yeah, some friends.
Yep.
That was our biggest pet turnout as well.
And a bird.
It was.
Yeah,
thank Nathan for that.
Yep.
Yep.
But I mean, it was just really good, and I mean, we're gonna go back there. I hope we never have to, but we'll be back there again.
Oh, absolutely. For sure.
I
think he'll miss us.
Yeah. He does miss us. I know. Bukkake definitely. Bukkake loves to drive through the protests.
Oh my God.
He does.
He loves to. I don't know why. Maybe he likes the attention. Maybe he's trying to catch some faces. Who knows?
Yep.
He's probably laughing, going, "I'm going to your house soon."
Yeah, right.
Yeah. Good.
Give me a call.
Come on over. Yeah,
come on over. You already got an invite.
We'll make you a meatball dinner.
Yeah.
But in all seriousness, people that are not involved in this, why are you at Morrissey's office? Why are you guys on the highway? Why are you guys in front of the courthouse? What are we going to do tomorrow? Right? Yeah.
We're going to fight. Yep.
We've been doing this. They got Aiden was organizing all these things when they first started going, and he couldn't anymore. So we sort of jumped in and helped out, and it just naturally evolved. But man, I want to put this out there. We're out here doing this, but we take no, this is everybody's credit. What's happening? I don't mean to jump in tomorrow. What's happening tomorrow is everybody's played a part in this. Whether you made a sign, whether you posted something on social media, Nick and Jenna Rocco raising money like crazy, Aiden, all the YouTubers, no matter what, whether you showed up at a protest or not, you wrote into the ACLU. Everybody played a protest in this. I mean, played a part in this. Mm-hmm. And that which was led to the court actually hearing us tomorrow. We hope.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
You know?
But that's why we're at Morrissey's office, because of, all this, because of everybody, for everybody, not just us three being there for everybody. Everybody that was there for everybody who couldn't be there on that day. And that's what this movement's all about, supporting each other and trying to, fight for what's right. And at this point, it's not just about Karen Reed, and it's not just about, justice for Officer John O'Keefe. Not for the Canton Nine, not just for Janelle and for Aiden. It's for our First Amendment rights now. They're attacking all of us now. They're not just attacking individual groups. They've come after the country, trying to stifle our First Amendment rights is just horrible. So here we go. Bring it on.
Whoops, I got lost here. Sorry. I'm back. My computer's doing funky things. But as I was doing that, I was thinking of something, and man, that train left the building like that.
Oh, see, you got too much spray tan in your room.
That's no spray tan. I don't spray tan. I refuse to do that. I do it the old fashioned way. I get in a tube.
Are you getting the tube?
And crank the cancer up on high.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God. That's horrible. Fantastic.
Listen, I did it once before. I went on a vacation on a cruise, and the first day I got burnt to a crisp.
Oh yeah, yep.
That happened to me too.
Horrible.
I'm like, I won't burn. I'm Italian, yeah. and I never recovered. Yeah. I blisters the whole first day.
Yeah,
first day I was in Mexico. It's horrible.
Mm-hmm. that sun down there is a little bit hotter.
Very, very hot.
Yep. But so again, Morrissey's office was a success. Everybody that showed up, like you said, Paul, the media being there.
Paul's interview was fantastic.
Paul did a great job. Well done. Well done.
Which one was that?
Scott McGinnis interview, your interview.
Oh, yeah, Scott. Yep.
Yep. Peter Murphy's interview. Everybody, it was great.
It was awesome.
I love the fact that they were there. Kristen Galvin was there reporting on it. And she was actually the reporter who was at the special town meeting that interviewed you as well.
Yeah.
Oh, did she say she remembered you, or when she called you, whatever the hell that go?
She saw me pictures of me, didn't remember me. She saw my name, didn't remember me. She heard my voice, and she goes, "Oh, I remember him."
It's priceless.
She was super nice when she came over the house too, so it was kind of cool.
Yeah. Oh yeah, absolutely.
That's awesome.
Speaking of that, can I jump into something? Like, of course. NBC10's really given us some good coverage, right?
Yeah, they have. Yeah.
And I've had some conversations with a couple of reporters over the past week or so. And it's some of them are amazed at the reactions they get from both sides. But one in particular said, through somebody else, so I can't quote him directly, but what he what a lot of times the confusion happens is we have the news comes out from the courthouse, whether it's the defense put something out or the Commonwealth put something out. So when the Commonwealth puts something out, the news has to report it. That's just that, that's a fact. But he was saying, I don't understand how everyone attacks me for just putting out the news. You know, so we got to keep that in mind. Like, and it's a friendly, you know, that mm-hmm. supports us a lot, supports everything, and has been doing it for a while. But if he says anything about the Commonwealth, we sort of Free Can't Read supporters sort of just jump on him. But the truth of the matter is, he's just reporting the news. We got to remember that, you know.
Well, going through the news in that regard, I mean, you got to kind of keep a neutral perspective, or at least present a neutral perspective. You can't, you know, pick a side. It's a, you know, but I'm sure everyone has their opinions. So,
yep.
Yeah, I get it. But yeah, you can't brutalize everyone, I guess.
Exactly. Yeah. You know? So I just wanted to put that out there because. And NBC10 right now is throwing some great stuff out there, but eventually they're going to put some stuff out that the Commonwealth puts up. So it's just that simple.
Mm-hmm.
And we don't want to attack our friends.
No, definitely not. Absolutely.
You know what I mean? They got to do their job.
Yeah. Not and this is what we asked for. Friends, this is what we asked for.
They're putting out both sides. Whereas a couple months ago, none of the media was putting out, they were putting out the Commonwealth side, period. Now we have news stations putting out both sides. And if you guys don't think tomorrow is important, I'm telling you that tomorrow could be a media circus tomorrow. Everybody's talking about it. Mm-hmm. And that's all from stuff that we've done in the past. And that's everybody. And we got to keep Tom away from the female employee, reporters, just so you know. Okay. We'll put that up there.
I'll take care of the freaking Tommy.
Tommy, atta boy.
I thought you were off the market, Tom.
But listen, speaking of Tom, listen, we're gonna give it up for Tom too. He's here, and we go through the YouTubers at the end, but Tom's here now, man. Listen, Tom is there every single time, beginning to end, usually an hour before the beginning and an hour after the end.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. You know, and he's a trooper boy.
Yeah, he is.
Yeah, he is. Absolutely. Tom, we thank you for everything you do. It's amazing.
Yeah, he's our constant.
You know? Yeah, and everybody always asks, is Tom going to be streaming? I'm like, well, I don't really have to reach out and ask him. Yes, he'll be there, you know.
The funny thing is, I do ask him every time.
I think I do too. But
I do, but I know he's going to say yes.
Yep.
So, what else
we got? Yeah, so I guess we can, let's see, real quick, Lauren has a date on the 23rd as well against KP. I don't think that's in Stoughton, I believe.
You know, Lauren's here. Yeah, that's Stoughton, right, Lauren?
Hey, there's Lauren. Hey, Lauren. We're just talking about you. And that's it. Donald, Paul, we can do standouts after the next thing. I guess we'll get someone we want to talk to.
Oh, we do?
Yeah.
A very special guest, you say?
Real quick. Yeah. Should we talk about tomorrow first or after?
I think we can do it during. We can start this process and then get right into tomorrow.
All right. No problem.
Yeah, we can talk about it together.
Yeah, we can talk about it together. It's a group effort.
It's a group. All right, we're gonna bring him on. Ready?
And everybody say welcome to
Peter Murphy.
Peter Murphy. Everybody knows Peter. Hey, Peter, welcome.
Afternoon. Good night. How we doing?
Good night. How are you?
How's everybody?
What's up, Peter?
How are we? Long time no see.
Yeah, you're looking right? funky. Yeah. You're looking funky fresh, just like the app, brother.
Yeah.
What a little adrenaline does to you after a couple of standouts with the Canton corruption team.
I'll tell you, Peter, it's been a crazy month. I mean, you were there, you know, speaking of standouts right off the bat, the standout spotlight and all, you know, you were very involved in the Canton election standouts. You guys were out during the week, and you had your truck all decked out with a signs on the back and driving around town. And, you know, how was that whole process? Are you going to talk a little bit about what you did over the month?
Sure. I mean, it was, we were out, I was out with a good collection of people, genuine people, truly sincere about the cause and the movement. And we actually were out Easter Sunday morning on a standout. We did the church and we did the police station, 1492 Washington Street, right in front of Chief Rafferty's building. And we probably had, we had a half dozen people there, and Reader actually showed up. It was a good standout. We were there for 3 or 4 hours.
Wow.
And there were a lot of horns and positive thumbs up, and it was good. It was a good day.
Did you notice like the feedback over the couple few weeks that we were out there, like kind of changing a little bit? It seemed like the tone of people driving by was, you know, the initial was like kind of a half-assed wave, maybe whatever, to, you know, leaning on the horn, and it seemed like the excitement level kind of grew and the support changed, I think.
No, you're right, Dan. It definitely did. And I think, I don't know, I attribute some of that to the fact that the defense team, you know, postured the information that they had received, as well as the prosecution on 3,174 pages of exculpatory, and made the recommendation, the U.S. Attorney General, U.S. Office, that it should not or did not warrant going to trial. And I think people saw that, and I think they reacted positively. And I noticed it. I commented several times. It was a good, I don't know, I'd say 300 to 400% increase in enthusiasm. And for some reason, we saw more men actively engaged in waving to us, putting the window down at a stoplight, giving us a thumbs up, whereas before they were on the steering wheel 10 and 2 and didn't want to engage us. And I think it finally got to them that, you know, they could come out a little bit and not be in fear. And fear is driving that town into the ground right now.
It really is. I think that, you know, one person, I won't mention any names, but one person was at the standout. And, you know, certain times people would drive by that she knew from town, and she'd almost kind of shelter her face like, oh, geez, I don't want them to see me out here, but right, I want to support the cause. So it's definitely, it's real, you know, it's definitely real. And it's so sad, you know.
It is. It's totally consuming. And, you know, it's generational. In other words, people will say, you know, gee, I really wish I could join you, Peter, and you know, had the fortitude and the courage to come out. But, you know, they're my age, we'll say, and then they've got a daughter or a son that's in their 40s, and then they've got children that are in the school system. And the intimidation factor that rings through the community at all those levels is just overbearing and overwhelming for them. Mm-hmm. And I get it. You know, I do get it.
Sure. Oh, absolutely.
It's one thing for you or me or Paul or somebody to stand out and take our lumps and bumps. But, you know, when you've got young kids or juvenile adolescent kids in school, it's a lot. It's a tough task.
Yeah, absolutely.
Peter and I talked to Peter about this last week too, and I know what he's talking about because I ran into a Boston police officer. You know, he had a jacket on. He had the little BPD pin on. So I asked him, "Are you a Boston police officer?" And he said, "Yeah." And I go, "I won't ask you your name because I know because I just knew." And I said, "You ever hear about the John O'Keefe?" Murder, Officer John Keith murder. He goes, "Heard of it. I worked with him in High Park." Yeah. I worked with him in High Park.
Yeah.
Nicest guy in the world, he says. I go, "So what do you think about it?" He went on and on about how he truly believes that the corruption in Canton runs deeper than any of us even know because of his stories. And he knows that Karen was set up. So I looked at him and I said, "Why don't you speak up then?" And he gave me the look. And I know what the look was. And me and Peter talked about it. He can't.
Mm-hmm. Right.
As much as we want him to, he's got a family. He's got stuff. And if he speaks up, I'm not a police officer. I don't pretend to be a police officer. But they have ways, and then next thing you know, he's fighting to feed his family.
Exactly.
My opinion is the only way they could stand up is as a group, they all stood up. And that's good. That would take a lot.
It would take a lot, Paul. And also, the old adage is strength in numbers. But you know what? If the administration puts a target on your back, which I've been told I have, even as a retiree, they can set you up. They can get you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And the rank and file know that.
So, and that's why I brought it up, because, I mean, we all know, a lot of us know Peter. If you don't know Peter, he's, I want to say 35 years you're a sergeant. Am I correct?
Not a sergeant for 35, but in law enforcement, 35.
35 years. But you were a sergeant in Canton Police Department. Whether you retired or not, man, it takes some balls to stand up like you are. Retired or not, it really does.
It's how I roll. I bought into the program. I've told you you guys this before. I bought into the program, the day I first saw it on TV and heard the first news broadcast, and then saw the state police, colonel get up and talk about what he talked about. And I'm going, well, gee, I guess it's what they're saying. I worked in the organization. I worked in the field. I never saw that corruption. So I believed it. And then April came around, and thank goodness Karen had a great defense team, and they started to swing the pendulum in the other direction. And then Aiden jumped in and he exposed a lot of stuff, and we were off and running sometime in the first week in April. And that's about the time that I actually spoke with the infamous Brilliance Auto Body guy, the taillight bandit.
Oh, yeah, right.
And, you know, it blossomed in front of me with the autopsy pictures. And I said, there's no way. There isn't any way. And I said, that's it. I'm out. I'm coming out. And I wasn't that I was sitting back, you know, hiding. It's just that I believed in the system. But I learned. I saw it as it was in its reality. And here I am.
That's incredible. I mean, like Paul says, it takes a lot of courage to come forward in that type of a position.
I said balls, not courage.
I know. PG. Family show. Tracy's here. I don't want to say that.
There's a lady.
There's a lady present.
Did you guys listen to the first song on the show?
Oh yeah. I forgot about that.
That was the song I picked. Oh, that's right.
Shit. All right.
Sorry.
I heard the back. I was in the back room and I started hearing stories about tan lines and Speedos. I said, oh my God, what am I getting involved with?
Yep. He was like, I don't know if I signed up for this. This isn't in my contract.
Right. Exactly.
Welcome to the new woke channel.
But so backing up a little bit, Peter, so you became a police officer in the 80s, is that correct? Or is it the 70s you were a special officer, and then the 80s you actually, how tell us a bit about that.
Yeah, so in the early mid 70s, I had taken a state police exam, and I was waiting to get on the state police. I had gotten a 96. I completed all the physical requirements, and at the same time I was a special police officer in Canton, which means I had police powers, but I had no civil service backing. So I was not in a civil service position where through attrition, I would get at some point an opportunity to become a full-time police officer. Then civil service exams were being given. I took an exam. I got a 96 and 97, became a permanent intermittent, which means you could work shifts. You did some cursory criminal law and constitutional law so that you could go out in the street and make arrests and carry a gun and so forth. Mm-hmm. And first aid. And that lasted, I believe, from somewhere around 1976 to 1982. In 1982, we had the Proposition 2.5 layoffs, and you know, the economy tanked, and towns got under that restriction, and they laid off 3 full-time police officers in Canton. And you know, the administration came to us, and there were like 10 of us, and they said, "You guys are sucking wind. You're not going to get a job for a long time. Proposition 2.5, we got to bring our guys back." So Fortunately, Westwood Police Department had lost two officers on a transfer to the MDC, which then later got absorbed into the state police. Mm-hmm. And I saw it in the Patriot Ledger. I applied, I interviewed, and went through the academy, and I worked there from came out of the academy December of 82, and I worked there until December of 86. And then I transferred back to Canton. Because once you're civil service status, you can, you know, move. You have transfer abilities, I guess.
So you say you got a 96 on the state police exam. How come you didn't pursue that?
It was tied up. You know, it was one of those deals where you were going to have to wait years. I had waited a long time. I had started a family. I just couldn't wait. I needed to get into the career field.
Sure. Oh, absolutely. Understandable. Sure. So then you went through all that and you were back in town, you were in Canton. And then, so how was that to be an officer in your own town the way, Canton was then?
Yeah. In other words, I had worked in the town and lived in the town, you know, most of my life, so that I knew all the streets. I knew their policies and procedures and their protocols and their SOPs. So I fit right in. And in other words, I didn't have to do any kind of field officer training. I just transferred and was handed a firearm and a cruiser key, and off I went on a midnight shift. I just jumped right into the water's fine.
So did your kids probably didn't get away with a lot in town, huh?
No, they had about 41 parents in town driving around in police cars. They didn't get away with much.
41 parents.
Oh, that's fantastic. So then you went through your career. You got promoted to sergeant.
That's correct. I transferred to Canton. Actually, I was on a sergeant's list in Westwood. I did well on the first time I took the exam, but then I transferred to Canton. So I was, I took the exam in 88 in Canton and got promoted to sergeant. And I was a sergeant from 88 until I retired in 2010.
Really? And then you retired. I understand you go out on, you got a charter boat or something like that. You had a business?
I developed one. I got my Coast Guard license and did some commercial chartering, commercial fishing once I retired.
Captain license?
That's correct. U.S. Coast Guard license. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, beautiful.
Yeah, at the time, I since sold it. It's nothing but a hole in the water that you pour money into. So it got to be way too expensive to play that game, and fuel got expensive. And
absolutely. Yeah.
So I began running boats for other boat owners because they had other jobs. They were electricians or whatever business they were in, and they had the boat as a side, and it worked out great for them because, you know, I could run the boat for them, and they'd get a charter fee of $1,200 to $1,400 for the day. They'd pay me, and they still kept their other real-time real job, so it worked out good for them.
Oh, that's beautiful. Yeah, you still get out on the water during the good weather or what?
As much as I can. Yeah, as much as I can. Try to. Are you a boater or a fisherman or?
Yes, no, I was in the Navy, so I've been. Oh. I'm not familiar with the water.
Yeah, you are.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Sure.
Lived out there, so.
Yeah.
Yeah. So anyway, so going back to the election. So what are your thoughts on the results? You know, I mean, I'm glad that Trish won. I thought Rita was. I thought Rita was a strong candidate going in. I'm very surprised. I mean, it was close. I don't know what the numbers were, the final numbers were, but
it was close.
It was close.
Yeah, it was. Yeah. And they had a big turnout. I don't know what the final number was. I haven't seen it. I mean, it is as late as this morning, they were still bantering 400 and something votes around, I think, that they hadn't decided on or something. So ballots. So. But I think it was close to 7,000, which is almost twice what it usually is in a major primary or presidential election, even. So.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Right. Yeah,
Larry, 35% was voted, which is high number for a small town.
Is it really? Wow.
Yeah, I saw that 35% today, Paul. Yes, you're right.
No, thanks, Paul. That's great.
I want to give it up to you three for a minute, because I don't know how you guys did it with everything going on, and you three were very involved in with the elections and supporting out there, supporting all of them. I could not manage to get out there for the life of me. I mean, seriously, I got to give it up to you guys. Great job.
Well, I know. I had the luxury of not having, you know, to go to work every day or drive back and forth to Connecticut, taking my college student back and forth to school as somebody else did. So, you know, I was on Easy Street. I just had to commute from the South Shore. But, you know, Dana and Tracy, they had their hands full.
Yeah, it was worth the effort. I mean, we were out there every weekend. I think I missed one day over the month of March on Sunday, so I had to drive my daughter back to school.
Right, right.
Tracy was there.
Yeah.
Pretty much every weekend as well. And it's, you know.
I missed a few, and it felt so bad. I just couldn't make it happen. And it was killing me. It was like absolutely killing me. Yeah. I just feel like it's, you know, like even with like Karen Reed, you feel like you're in the area, you're local. It's local enough to just get in the car and go there. So why aren't you there, kind of thing? Mm-hmm. For me, anyway, that's how I feel. So
You can't be hard on yourself that way, Tracy.
No, I know.
You have other facets of your life that you have to address, and you know, that have to take a precedent over. As much as you want to be there and committed to it and genuinely interested, and you just, some days you just can't get there from there.
Yeah. And I say the same thing to other people. You know, you just can't get there. Family first, health is first. You got to take care of, you know, what's under your roof first, and you know, and then support if you can. So
right.
You know, I give the same advice, but I don't take my own advice.
Well, speaking of Rita, actually, I got something that she asked me to read.
Oh.
I reached out to her just to ask how she was feeling. She said, "I'm tired, but feeling so very good." She had a shift today till 8 o'clock, so she's working. Hasn't been able to get online this morning to post thank yous to everyone, so I'm assuming she will. She said, "Let everybody know that the election is over, and it was historic in so many ways and so much to be proud of, that my focus is shifting back to the select board meetings, the police audit, and Karen Reed."
Awesome.
I know many love to hear it, and I will be at court. Yes, I will be there tomorrow morning, ready to rumble.
Rita.
Exactly.
We'll get it going for her.
Yeah, so Rita's, you know, she's feeling better, you know, health-wise, and she, you know, the election knocked the hell out of her. She was pretty sick, you know, and she's, she's back up and running, and she's ready to go. And the fight is different, you know. The police audit, I think, is going to be the next big focus for them. They're going to still go to the select board meetings. You know, Tom Theodore was the one who shut down the public comments, said it would be reinstated for the next meeting, which is this coming Tuesday, the first one. I don't know how it works like that. Do they dethrone Tom right away? Like, will he not be there on Tuesday and Trish will be there?
Yeah.
As far as I know, Tom won't be there. And Trish was sworn in this morning. So I'm pretty sure she's going to be taking up one of those chairs, and you're not going to see Tom sitting there.
That's going to be crazy.
That's super exciting.
Yeah, it really is. Yep.
So happy for Trish.
Yeah. She ran a great campaign as well. You know, she had a lot of support, and, you know, obviously the numbers show it. You know, Rita was, you know, so close. But I'm proud of all of them. You know, Rita, totally. Kathleen, Jennifer. What happened with Kathy Gibbs McCormick? Did she?
She got in. I believe she got in.
I didn't get an update on that.
Yeah. Oh, perfect.
Excellent. Mm-hmm. Good.
Yeah. Well, I sent I sent the same type of thread out yesterday morning to about, I think the polls open at 7, Dana. So I sent a message to all the candidates about 6:30. Knowing they were up and probably getting ready to start to, you know, show up at the polling booths and vote or whatever. And I said, look, at win, lose, or draw, you guys won. I said, you have been so courageous to do what you have done. You have pushed the envelope down, you know, and just brought the town to a whole new level of realization and perhaps believability that things can get better and heal through transparency, accountability, trust, and healing. That, you know, hopefully is going to make the town go from a fractured community into a unified village again. And I think they're going to do it. And I said to Rita this morning, I said, look at, you know, look how effective you've been just at the select board meetings and, you know, peripheral, you've been able to pull a lot of stuff together. If you were on a select board, you'd have to, you know, be more constricted and regimented in what you say and what you do. And I said, you got free range chicken going now. You can hammer away at whoever you want, however you want. And you're going to do more positive things for the town than you probably could have done in a year's work sitting at the select desk.
Mm-hmm. Well, Jen O'Donnell wrote a big thank you. She posted on the pages today, and she basically said the same type of thing you're saying, Peter, is, you know, I'm not restricted. You know, I didn't win the election, but you know what? Now you have all of me, and there's nobody to tell me, you know, who else I should be. And it's fantastic because her passion and what she brings to the table, all of them. I'm looking forward to the next select board meeting to see how this all unfolds.
Oh boy. Yeah.
Yeah. It's going to be wild.
Yeah, exactly.
I have to switch the picture around because I'm watching that cat in the background and he's ready to pounce.
Right. And that's a railing. So that goes down quite a bit.
Yeah.
And she's
coming this way.
Yeah, she's coming.
Oh, Jesus.
She knows what I'm talking
about. Sorry, I interrupted you, but I was sidetracked by a cat.
Yeah.
Oh, now she's climbing the wall. Yeah, she literally climbs the wall.
Later.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Yeah, she's out of her mind. So I guess we move on to the matter at hand, and we're going to talk about tomorrow.
I agree.
Yeah, I think that you know, tomorrow's a huge day. You know, the motion that the DA's office tried to pass, telling us that we have to be back 500 feet, we can't wear Karen Reed gear and all this other nonsense, it's so unheard of. And it's so against everything that this country stands for. So here we go.
Here we go. It's going to be interesting. And as you said, I think there's going to be an awful lot of media there because this is, I mean, this obviously, it affects them. First Amendment, it impacts them. They got to buy into this. They got to see it.
Mm-hmm. Tomorrow's going to be huge.
Yeah.
I don't, like, me, Tracy, and Dana were talking the other day, and this is before the ACLU came up. Okay. And I could probably ask almost everybody in the chat. Last Easter, let's just use that as a guideline.
Okay.
Did anyone have this on your bingo card?
No.
Anybody?
No. Nope. Yeah, exactly.
You know, and I put it out there on the pages, and I put it on the pages. Like, we have Mark Rendanza. How am I saying it wrong?
Rendaza. There's no.
Well, if Billy gets my name right, I'll get his name wrong. But anyway.
You got my name right.
Between that and the ACLU and all that, this wasn't no magic bullet that happened overnight.
Oh.
This, everybody in our groups, anyone that has played a part in this, I think I said it already, but I'm going to give a quick story about the ACLU. Okay. So we put it out there, last week,
mm-hmm.
about calling and emailing the ACLU, right?
Right. Yep.
By the time I talked to him, because I was telling Peter beforehand, I put this out and said, you know, let's everyone call and email. I go, wait a minute, I never called. I didn't do anything. So I called, right? And it said an email, and then I'm telling the lady. The lady goes, oh my God, I have never got so many calls and emails about an issue. What are you doing to me? And my first response real quick was making you do your job.
Yeah, right. Yeah. Nice. Well done. Yep.
But it was just it was in a humorous way. It wasn't bad.
Yeah.
And then
and then
somebody posted today that they called yesterday and they were told that they have not received this many calls and this many emails about a certain subject in a long time.
Wow.
And we've had a lot of stuff go on over the past few years. In Massachusetts.
Yeah.
So this hearing tomorrow is a result of everybody's effort.
Yeah.
Everybody's effort. I think I can put it out there now.
It sounds like you're going to.
I have a tough time with it. Okay, so he didn't tell me we couldn't say it, so I'll say it anyways. And if I didn't, we are not the four people that got on to the motion. Nick Rocco, he did a great job. He raised the money. Nick did, and it was a fast moving thing. He picked the names that he thought were best for this motion. I didn't care who you would have picked. That wouldn't bother me whatsoever. But I want to let you know, one of the first questions that Mark asked us, the four of us, was, because we're on this motion, we are an object of the court. I think that's the word he said.
Okay.
And because we're the object of the court, Bev could turn around and say, okay, I'm going to deny the motion, but these four can't protest out front. That's really what was told to us.
Mm-hmm.
And there wasn't a hesitation between any of us. We said we'd absolutely do it because, you know something? The group is more important than either one of us. And we firmly believe that. It's a long shot, don't get me wrong, that the court would do that. But it is a possibility. So he wanted to give us that warning.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So we're not taking this lightly. We're not taking it like this is our motion. This is everybody's motion. Everybody's. They need four names up there, and here we are. You know what I mean? And it's big stuff tomorrow. Like, I've talked to a couple of people today that aren't involved in it. And like, I 100% believe Karen Reed's factually innocent. That's why I'm here.
Right.
It snowballed to 28,000 people in a Facebook group for the most part.
Right.
Are going to court tomorrow to fight for our First Amendment rights, not just for us, but as Mark said, 7 million people in Massachusetts. And there's people all over the country talking about this now.
Absolutely.
You know, so everybody that's in this group, from Turtle Boy down to Nathan, the dog, there's no in between, but I'm just saying everybody should be proud of what's going on.
Absolutely. 100%.
You know, I really wanted to put that out there. And at the same time, I got to put some public service announcements. I put them out there in the chat. In that group today.
Okay.
Tomorrow's the day that the media, the courts, the people are going to be watching us like a hawk out front.
Mm-hmm.
Tomorrow's the day when a fake witness comes up to us and says something, we don't respond.
Right.
If somebody's there just to antagonize us, because there are people out there that have nothing to do with the case that see an opportunity to cause a scene. We don't respond with them. You know, we kill them with kindness. And if you can't kill them with kindness, be quiet. That's it.
No, as you know, I think the theme a couple of hearings ago, universally, was when the adversaries walk towards the courthouse, just turn your backs. Mm-hmm. That way they can't make any allegations or claim anybody threatened them or used a bad word. Just turn your back on them.
Yeah, like I said, I know none of us are very fond of some of the witnesses. They're criminals. We know that. But tomorrow's not the day. We're gonna have plenty of time once Josh comes in to have our say with them. We're gonna have plenty of time.
Plenty.
Because like I said the past couple of weeks, I don't care who you are, I don't care about anyone else. Karen's going to be innocent. Karen's going to be out. She's going to be doing what she's doing. And these guys are going to be going to a trial. I'm still going to be out front there.
Same.
Right. Yeah, absolutely.
All this justice for John.
Right.
Yep.
You know, so that's my spiel. A little, excited about it because a year ago, I didn't get this stuff. Didn't excite me. It didn't.
Right.
I'd be sitting on TV going, oh, look at these guys and change the channel. That's the truth.
Yeah.
So, but you're right. You're right, Paul. I've been there, you know, for, I guess, probably almost 100% of the hearings. And as you get up, you know, whether you're down on the sidewalk, we've seen some adversaries come in and try to stir the pot. They've, you know, yelled at Aiden, yelled at some of us. You guys know who I'm talking about. Mm-hmm. And then you get upstairs and you're trying to get into the main courtroom door to where you go through the metal detector. And people start chirping up there. And, you know, as you say, they try to incite.
They try.
And cause, you know, a bad scene. And, you know, fortunately, we've got a very reserved bunch of people and we don't buy into it.
This will be a dumb question for Tracy and Dana. Anyone like hockey? Right?
Yeah.
So what I'm saying, I know Tracy. Yeah,
they love
hockey. I know. Yes.
You watch hockey long enough and Marshawn comes up and gives somebody a little give somebody a little jab or maybe lick his face, right?
All right.
The guy reacts. That guy gets the penalty, not Marshawn. Right.
Always. Right. Yeah.
Yeah. Always yeah. The person that reacts gets the penalty. It's right. The same yeah. Thing. Right. And I'm not, you know, listen, Tracy, Dana, and I fully 100%. Tomorrow we're talking about the First Amendment. So we can't come on here and tell you guys what to do.
Right.
No, it's right against what we're fighting for.
Yeah, right.
We're giving suggestions. And Peter said something else too that was stressed to us. Whatever we do tomorrow, do not impede anybody's progress to get into the courtroom by accident. Not even by accident.
Right.
When I say everyone's going to be watching, you know, the worst thing I want to be is be in the courtroom tomorrow and someone goes, oh, I had a tough time getting up the stairs because they wouldn't let me go by.
Right.
Yeah.
Imagine that. Mm-hmm. So that's what I'm talking about. And the other thing, and one more quick thing, and then I'll shut up, maybe, is anyone that has them and wants to bring them, tomorrow is the perfect time for our First Amendment signs. Tomorrow's a perfect time. Listen, your free Karen Reed signs, your free Turtle Boy signs, bring them. That's yep. Great. But bring the first, if you have a First Amendment sign, bring it. Because that's what this hearing isn't about X's and O's in the trial. This hearing, as far as we know, is strictly about this buffer zone.
Mm-hmm.
Restricting our First Amendment rights as United States citizens to sit out on the sidewalk and hold signs and voice our opinions so the press can see it, so the public can see it, so the public will watch the trial
right.
And watch exactly what's going on.
Exactly.
So I'm a little excited, huh?
Yeah. Yeah.
You're passionate.
You need a vacation or something.
I know. You need to go on vacation, Paul. Jeez.
What was that?
You need a vacation or something.
I do. I need a vacation.
Yeah.
Oh, it's going to be tough on vacation, boy.
Yep.
I have a couple things. I just want to give a shout out to Lorena, our fourth.
Yes.
She's not, you know, out in the open and like we are as far as getting our voice out, but she's in the comments. All right.
Yep.
And she's all over Facebook and she's a trooper. So she's going to be representing tomorrow as well. So I just want to give her a shout out because she's been doing awesome with getting all this stuff together.
Yep.
And I also want to give out a shout out to Minion Mike. He's not feeling well. He's doing fine. But he won't be there tomorrow because he is he's just waiting for a bunch of things to be scheduled, some tests to be scheduled, some surgeries, that kind of thing. But he is fine. He wants everyone to know that he's gonna miss us all. And he actually called me to tell me that he wouldn't be there. And he's devastated. So I said, all right, Peter, you gotta take care of yourself first. You gotta health, family. Yep. You gotta take care of that stuff. And we know he's there in spirit. So I just wanted to say hi, Mike. And
thank you, Mike.
We'll be thinking about you.
Mike, you'll be with us. Trust me, you'll be with us.
Can I come pick up the lunchbox?
You got to go up and drive into about a 4.5 snow to get it. People don't realize how far he comes from. All I know. These things.
Every time.
Yeah. He's up north. To ride. Yep.
Every time. No, that's all.
I think he was here earlier too. On here,
was he?
Yeah.
Oh, no, he was in the glare, right?
No, he was on here. I saw him chime in at one point. He said, hello,
okay.
My name is.
Oh, okay. Hi, Mike.
So speaking of a courtroom, I have one story that I love to share. And Peter, we talked about this earlier, but when you left the courthouse that one day for the last Karen date, cat. Sorry, I got distracted. The cat.
The cat's trying to rip the place apart.
I'm not the only one being distracted by cats.
Yeah, I know. So you came out of the courtroom and you were welcomed. A very warm reception from the crowd. It was fantastic. It was great to see because I think it was something that was due. You know, you've come forward, you've stepped forward, you've made a name. Everybody knows who Peter Murphy is now. And it's great because you went from one position where I'm not really vocal, I'm not forward about it, to, okay, you know, this is wrong. What's wrong is wrong. And I'm going to speak up and I'm going to have a voice. And you do. And people see that and people appreciate that. And especially because of your background, people really appreciate it. So what was your take on that when you walked out of the courtroom? I'm sure you weren't really expecting that.
No,
nobody would, right?
No, I wasn't expecting it, and you know, to speak to what you've just said, is there is no I in the word team. And I mean, you know, I've done pretty much anything and everything I can do, but that goes for so many other people that are down on the sidewalk or can't make it there but are watching on a live stream somewhere. So I had that, as I do routinely, I usually wait up outside the main courtroom for the defense and Karen and her family to come out. And I just say hi and wish them well and stay strong. And on that particular morning that you're speaking about, Karen's sister came out and said hi. And she said, I want you to meet my dad. And she pulled her dad out of line. And it was a very emotional moment for both him and I. I mean, very emotional. It was just that. And so we walked down the stairs together and he went into the other courtroom, and then he saw me standing out by the metal detector and he felt that it was necessary for him to come out again and just gave me a hug and a shake of the hand and thanked me again for stepping out and stepping up. Mm-hmm. So I was emotionally drained. I mean, I was cooked. That was one of the more emotional moments I've had in my lifetime in a long time. Sure. And then when I walked out to that, chant Peter, I'm going, oh my God, what do I do with this? I was speechless. And that's why I kind of went like this with my fingers and just pointed to the crowd saying, it's not me, it's you.
Yeah.
I didn't convey that, but I hope that my body language expressed it.
I think it did.
We totally got it.
So are we talking about Kelly?
Yes.
Kelly, not Karen's sister.
Kelly's cousin.
Cousin, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. Yes. Yeah.
We don't want to get that all involved. Who knows?
No. Right.
Whoa.
Exactly. Yeah. She was great. And, you know, I had said hi to her father many times. And Karen, you know, knows who I am. It was a special moment with her dad. You know, he's such a strong family, but you know, her dad is so strong.
Yeah.
He's America's father right now.
I can't imagine, you know, and that's one of the things people have said to me, you know, you stand to lose so much, Peter. Why are you coming out and speaking against this and speaking up? And I said, it's simple. That could be my daughter, that could be your daughter, for one thing. You know, how are you gonna sit on your hands and watch this and send an innocent person to jail? Can't do it. So that's where we're at, all of us.
Awesome.
Well, I love it. I think about that story often. You coming out was an amazing thing to see, and the welcome that was, you know, the reception that you received was, you know, again, it was warranted, you know. So
well, thank you for that, Dan. I mean, I appreciate you know, the support that you're giving me, and I appreciated it that day immensely. But I didn't expect it. And, you know, there isn't probably anyone down on the sidewalk at some point that could could not be justified to get the chant themselves. So we're all in it. There's no I in the way, chant.
Right. Yep, I agree.
That's the thing, you know, that throughout this whole movement.
What's there's that? A man. My boss used to say that. I'd be like, there's a me. Huh? Thanks.
I was saying, throughout this whole movement, though, I mean, we've met so many, the people, we say that every week, I think, but the people are what keep this together, what keep this going, because the people we've met, it just, it's amazing, you know. Otherwise, we wouldn't be friends, and we wouldn't have met Paul, Peter. We would have never, you know, I would have never met you, and we never would have never met any of these people. And the fact right. that we do, and we see them, hell, I see these people more than I see my own family, you know. So it's really no, it's incredible.
The sincerity and the genuineness of the people from this movement, you know, it's just incredible. Take Sean down in Naples, Florida. He didn't know me, even though he lived in Canton. He graduated a few years after me. He and I didn't know each other. And, you know, he saw me come out and donate to Karen's team and fund. And he said, damn, he said, I'm 1,500 miles away. If this guy can do it living, you know, close proximity and haven't been on the job, why can't I? And he'll tell you that story. You know,
so that's how you guys connected.
That's it.
Yeah. And wow, no kidding.
And I, you know, I've told him many times, I said, damn it, if we ever come back again in this lifetime and, you know, you're looking for a new boots on the street, I said, I'll come work for you. We'll go into sure. the jungle in Bogota and we'll we'll capture some baddies.
There you go. Well, I love it. Yeah, listen, I love it.
I put this up here because I know not everyone's religious or anything, but, you know, I am. And, like, I truly believe God works through people. You know, and God put the situation in fact to bring us all together. We're here for a reason. Yeah, but I don't want to get all political. I don't need any messages, but that's how I believe, you know. God's working through Karen. God's working through everybody involved to bring all these people together to bring get things better in the state. I really believe that.
I do, too.
Like you say, you know, they say he has a plan, right? So
yeah,
this has got to be the plan. So here we go. But looking forward to tomorrow. I'm not going to lie; it's a little unnerving to be going in and standing, you know, being in front of Auntie Bev like that. I'm
scared to death.
Yeah.
Spit it out there.
I'm not gonna lie. It's, you know, I'm not a big fan of going to courtrooms when I'm the one that has to be you know, spoken to or about, you know.
Yeah, so, exactly.
It's a whole
there is a thing. Chance we have to testify, but I think it's very, very slim.
Yeah, think, exactly.
Yeah, Mark will do all the talking.
I hope you're right.
Yeah. He's a character, I'll tell you what. I don't know if everybody saw him.
No, I haven't.
On last night, oh my goodness,
he's awesome.
I want to see how he turns it off in a courtroom.
Yeah, you actually see him in that,
because we have a conversation with him straight up.
Oh my God, so funny.
It'd be interesting.
Man down.
Broke something.
Uh oh.
So, Peter, did you see Mark at all? Did you watch? I think it was Aiden had him on last night.
No, I didn't. I did the campaign standout yesterday from 10:30 in the morning till 7:30 in the dark and the rain.
Then
I brought signs to Rita's house. I got home about, I don't know, probably 9:15.
Wow.
Grabbed a quick bite to eat. I was cooked. I slept
great. I bet. That's a long, long day. It's been a long month. March went on for it was a marathon for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know? But was there something you wanted to mention, Dana, about that last night, or?
Oh, Mark.
No, just Mark Randazzo. He's a character. Yeah. So if you get a chance even to turn it on for like 2 minutes, you'll get the gist of who he is. And, you know, if you read the motion that he filed, it's very colorful. He has a lot to say, and he's very descriptive. It's 21 pages, but it's well worth the read. And it's, you know, he points out, he does a lot of bringing a lot of different cases and examples and that type of thing. And I know that goes, you know, for what it's worth in most courtrooms. that sure. goes a long way, because I know Aiden's what's his name, the judge that Aiden was up against. You know, do you have this in you know, do you, what Krupp? He was a very he's a stickler for you know, well, what case law do you have in this type? Right. So Rendaza's actually, he's pulled a lot of information in, so I give him a lot of credit, not knowing him going into it to see what he's presented on this behalf of all of us is it's great. So, but he he's a character.
Well, I'm looking forward to seeing him live tomorrow too. I'm gonna preview that tonight, but I can't wait to see him go to tomorrow.
Yeah, no, absolutely. Yeah.
So, another real quick thing is, when you guys are done watching us, right? If you have a Twitter account, go on Twitter.
Look, don't tell people to go on Twitter.
Everyone will thank me.
All right.
Go to Turtle Boy's account and watch his video of Ken Mello.
Oh, okay.
All right.
Make sure you're near a bathroom, because you're going to laugh so hard you're going to pee.
Oh, shit. Okay. Yep. Yeah, that, see that
comment,
right there, that was actually in the motion.
We are the OGs of liberty in Massachusetts.
That's insane. That's in a court motion document.
Mm-hmm. The OGs.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's it. What did he say? You get what you pay for.
He's very, awesome, very using very colorful language, and it's but it is well written. I mean, what's the DUI guy went over it, will begin to go over it tonight, and in reading it and hearing it back again, you know, for the 100th time at this point for myself, he really gets his point across. You know, we're just hoping that it's received well by the court.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, tomorrow's gonna be a hell of an interesting day.
It is.
But
what do you think's gonna happen, Peter? I know what you hope will happen, but what do you think is going to happen?
In specifically tomorrow, Tracy? Or
yeah, what do you think the judge is going to do?
Tomorrow?
Yeah.
I don't know. I mean, the way things have been ruled on in that court and taken under advisement, and I came out of court the other day, and I forget who I was talking to. It might have been Mike Rodot or somebody, and I said, that court is it's a comic strip up there. It's a cartoon. So I don't know what's going to happen. I wish I could be more philosophical, but I really don't know. I guess this is kind of like breaking ground as far as ever putting a buffer around a courthouse, isn't it? I mean, I don't know that. I haven't researched it, but
it's happened before.
Yeah, I think Dedham did it at least twice in the past.
In the recent past, or
13 years ago was the last one.
Yeah.
Do you happen to remember what trial it was, Paul, or what the case was?
The puppy dough trial. The difference, though, is it was an animal activist type thing. We're out front. The difference is the defense requested it, not the prosecution.
Right. Yeah.
Okay. Well, and
go ahead.
Are they worried about, I mean, is the court worried about prejudicing the jury, or are they worried about the verbal abuse that assistant DA Lally takes when he comes 20 minutes late?
I think that rubbed him the wrong way for sure.
They're a little worried about the jury, but they're a lot worried about the public opinion of what's going on in that court. That's why we're there tomorrow.
Right.
Yeah.
You know,
right.
That's last ditch effort.
Mark said it best as far as like talking about like the defense doing it last time. He put it in the motion. The government's putting this thing. Government has no rights. The government has power.
Right.
We have the rights.
Correct.
Very important.
Right. Correct. Yeah. Well, we're going to bring it tomorrow, hopefully.
All right. Yep. Someone was right on board with me there, huh?
Yep.
Thank you. KMM's on it.
Mm-hmm. We'll get a chance to see Marky Mark do his thing.
And the ACLU. I don't know. Do people realize that the ACL is going to be represented there?
Yeah, they're going to be there.
You told me that earlier. I wasn't aware of that. Yeah.
Yeah. They're going to be there tomorrow.
Wow.
So
that's a huge day.
Yeah, if you look up.
It is, and not even just for this case in general, like surrounding Karen Reed, but in general surrounding the First Amendment. I mean, this is a big, it's really big. So I'm glad that, you know, we're all a part of it. If we can change, you know, some kind of a law down the line, I don't know how that all process would unfold, but if that be the case, I'd be more than excited to say, look at what we all did collectively. You know, writing to the ACLU, everything. It's incredible.
But don't sell yourselves short. I mean, you guys are the four, you know, you were certainly instrumental as far as pushing the envelope to get us to the point where you got an attorney. And obviously, you know, the money issue was raised rapidly by Rocco, I guess. Is that correct?
Nick put it out there and raised the money in like two and a half hours, I think.
Yeah. So, I mean, again, there's a fly in the word team, but it's incredible that somebody took the initiative and carried the ball down the sidelines and took it in the end zone. And tomorrow's the end zone.
It's a team effort.
Yeah.
I don't even know if Tracy and Dana saw this yet. It looks kind of eerie.
What?
On the court docket, when you look it up, it says the movements, which are us.
Oh, yeah. It says defendants.
Listed as defendants.
Defendants.
Like the old days, Paul.
Yeah. I don't know what you're talking about, Peter.
I think they were just too lazy to write us all in.
Yeah, there we go. I love this line too from Mac.
Yeah, that was awesome.
Yeah.
Oh, that's great. Go on the check bender. Yeah.
Will couldn't get over that when he was going over it on the glare.
That's wild.
Yeah, it's going to be an interesting day. But well, Peter, I appreciate you joining us. We'll let you scoot.
Yeah,
but okay. We will see you. We'll see you in the morning.
Yeah,
you'll be there. I usually get there sometime around 0700 hours.
Yeah, you do.
You know, so I am not going to lose prime real estate upstairs tomorrow. I will be there if I have to stand in the rain. I'll be there. So,
well, yeah, dig out your old captain's fishing gear and leather up.
My oil skins and my Grundons. Yep. Okay. Yeah.
There we go.
All right. Well, thank you. Thank you for the invitation. It was fun. It was good to get some information out there. And, you know, I consider you guys new besties just from this movement alone over the last couple of months. Sincerely. Absolutely. I mean that. I'm not blowing smoke. That's true.
No, appreciate it. I feel the same.
Yep. We love you.
All righty. Okay. Have a good rest of the night.
Thanks, Peter. We'll see you in the morning.
You will. All right. Thank you. Have a great night, everybody.
Take care.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Awesome.
Look at that.
Peter's awesome.
I love it. That was great. I love it. That was fun.
Yeah.
Some great stories.
Yeah. It will never get old with him. I talk to him. He'll either text me or call me like every other day and just tell stories, and I just listen.
Yeah, such great stories. What does Colleen calls him? Papa.
he
reminds her of a papa.
Yeah.
The hugs and the stories.
Papa Smurf.
Yeah.
That's what he reminds me of. Remember that, Smurfs?
Yeah, he's all wise and knowing. Yeah. And just gathered all the Smurfs.
It looks like Colleen has Aiden as a daddy and Peter as a papa.
Oh God, Colleen, settle down.
Take it easy, yeah.
All right, what else we got?
She's gonna kill me.
Yeah,
I know.
So, Paul, I know you're getting ready to go away on your vacation. I just saw your message reaching out about standouts. Did you get any feedback on any of that stuff?
The regular standouts over the weekend is Plymouth and Bourne. That's all I have so far.
And I hear weather-wise, it might be shitty out on Saturday, so we'll have to kind of keep everybody up to date.
The standout for Sandra Birchmore was changed to Sunday, correct?
Yep, correct. 12 to 3 at the Stoughton Town Hall. So, I don't know what else is going on. We'll try to keep everybody updated. Everything in the next week, if you want to funnel things through Tracy and I.
I was going to say the same thing.
Yeah, so we can keep everybody up to speed and what's going on with all the standouts for the next week. And, you know, we got court dates next week. And was it next week? I don't know. I can't. the week after. It's all blurred together. I don't know what the hell's going on.
There's another court date next week, April 12th.
Yeah, okay, that's right. Yeah, so there is, it is next week. All right.
Just so you know, Dana, I think Tracy was there. We were talking about doing the show, and sometimes being on the show by yourself is kind of odd. It's almost like you're talking to yourself. Like if I was on here and Tracy and Dana weren't there, I'd feel a little self-conscious, like I'm talking to myself. We're both here. It's like we're having a real conversation sitting in our living room. Well, next week, Tracy and Dana are going to be out here by themselves.
I know.
Oh, shit. We have to get a special guest or somebody to talk to the whole show.
It's someone, Melby.
Well, we did that last week.
Yeah. I got to be real quiet, though. Make sure you tell me when the show is, because maybe I'll pop on.
I'm telling Julie.
Yeah, I know. Julie's going to be pissed.
I'm telling.
She's watching now going, that asshole. I
know. Thank God she doesn't watch these shows back.
So yeah, we'll keep everybody up to date on the standouts as we hear about them again. This weekend is going to be, this weather just is horrible. Bring on the spring, for God's sakes. But Saturday, that's what they say, but for the love of God, it seems like it's been raining for a freaking year now. That's really all I got. Julie Grant was my freaking apology.
Still waiting for his apology from Julie Grant. Seriously. I don't think you're going to get it, Dana.
I'm still going to keep asking. I don't give a
shit. Oh, that's a good idea for Michelle.
What?
You guys go in separate rooms on two different screens.
There you go. That would be different.
Yeah. Two screens lead to separate bedrooms. Who knows?
What the hell?
You smiled too much for that, Tracy.
I know, I'm a little too giddy.
She's like, hey, get the hell out of here.
Yep, Mizzy, we'll be there on Sunday. Thank you for keeping us updated.
Yep.
I'm looking up something because I thought I had something, but maybe I don't.
Yeah, while you're looking up something, again, we want to give a typical shout out to all the content creators. There's actually too many to list at this point. I can't even go through. It's like,
yeah, we just thank everybody.
Coming out. What's her name? Who was that girl that was on with Plevin earlier that Will was making, just killing on Plevin?
Oh,
Lauren Laguna. Is that right?
Lauren Laguna. Yeah. Oh my God. She was bashing him. It was awesome. Priceless.
She's been on the show before, right?
I got to watch it on Will's channel because I won't watch it.
Yeah. You got to hear Will's commentary.
I won't give Plevin the like with all the view. I'm all set with that guy.
Yeah.
A lot of people are asking about Zoom for tomorrow. There will be a Zoom, I'm sure, for the hearing tomorrow. But I know Aiden will be streaming. And I'm sure some other people will be out there streaming it too.
Yeah, Mike Crawford's always streaming. The regular streamers will.
Just so you know, I don't know the name of her channel, but if you Google her, Lauren Laguna has her own channel. And they simulcast. So she had it on her channel too. So you could always go over her channel and watch it. So you don't have to give Kevin any views.
Yeah, exactly. But she was just putting him in his place. It was fantastic.
Yeah, she was pretty awesome. Yep. And just had, just didn't. And furthermore, she was just on him. It was awesome.
Yeah.
The answer to that question someone asked, do we think Bev will let Mark talk? We don't know.
Yeah, we really have no idea what to expect tomorrow.
I don't think Bev thought we were going to come in with an attorney. Yeah.
They didn't think. No. No way.
They definitely didn't think the ACLU was coming in.
Yeah, for sure. And they got all cameras on them. So we'll see how she wants to act, to see what direction she wants to take this. So
I think Lally's going to come in a little red-eyed tomorrow. He's not sleeping tonight.
No, I don't think he's slept in like 6 months. Just coming in whenever he wants.
Well, that's the thing, though. I mean, we go into this motion tomorrow. I mean, if she says, well, too bad, you can't protest 500 feet, we're going to instate that, then, she's just crushing our First Amendment rights, and she's going to look horrible, and it's just gaining more and more traction. I think the DUI guy said it yesterday. He says, it's already being seen across the country and, you know, all over the world at this stage. If she does this and denies it, I mean, she pushes this through and we can't protest like we want to, it's going to get bigger and it's going to get bigger. That's what they don't want.
And that's what Mark was saying. They'll resort to other things within the law that you dish something out to them. They're going to use it to their advantage to come up with something else where they, mm-hmm. their voices will be heard.
Yep.
So what do you want? That, you know, like, that's a decision she's going to have to make.
Before we go, there was a lot of talk about raising the money and where the money was going, better spent elsewhere. Listen, we got our $6,000 worth already.
Yeah, we did.
We did. Whether it gets heard or not, we got our $6,000 worth already. And I hope it's heard and I hope it's changed, but regardless, the press, it's spreading like wildfire. You'll see.
Yep.
You will see that, for example, I'm talking about even the county retrial, like Larry, the DUI guy, he's flying in for the trial.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know who the other one was. Someone mentioned earlier, we have people from all over the country going to be flying, and Vinny's going to be here for the trial.
Yeah.
That'd be so awesome.
You know, so.
Yeah.
Hey, Mazda, nice to see you, brother.
There he is.
He's our Twitter warrior.
Yeah, he is. Well done. I love it. He's got a great voice.
It is.
Yeah.
I like that voice. I like it.
You like it?
I like it.
He could be David Allen Boucher's substitute.
Yeah.
Showing my age here.
I know. That was bad. Yeah, and I agreed with you, so I did it.
Yeah.
All right. Do we have anything else?
No, I think that's it. I mean, tomorrow, 9 o'clock. Is when it all starts.
People are going to be there at 7, right? 7, yep. 7:30, right?
Exactly. Yep.
The weather's going to be rough, guys, so plan accordingly. You know?
Yeah, weatherproof your signs, wrap some clear tape around it or something.
Saran wrap.
Saran wrap. Yeah, exactly. Yep. You know, whatever
people
you
do that. I've seen it.
Yeah, it works great.
Yeah, it works.
Some tape, some Saran wrap. Yeah. Keep it on the roll. You just kind of,
Exactly.
You know what I'm talking about.
Yes. I'm going to add that to the kit, actually.
Yeah, we got to add that.
The sign repair kit that we keep in the vehicle. Yeah. Add some Saran wrap.
It's funny. I'm going to be there a little late tomorrow because I have to.
Unacceptable.
I do have a real job.
No, I'm just. Oh! What?
No, meaning we all have real jobs. I didn't think no one had real jobs. I meant I have to take care of my real job. That's what I meant. Nice. That came out wrong. Sorry.
Yeah.
No, I need to
I know it did.
I'm going to be a little late, but the truth of the matter is I know what I'm going to be doing while I'm at work. I'm going to have Tom CPU on.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
what's the difference?
Every time.
Yep.
I love the ride in too. You don't miss it. You don't miss it. Anything. You don't miss anything.
Yeah, the conversations on the ride in it's half the show.
Yeah. So
before that ends up on Twitter for some troll, like, listen, what I meant was I have to take care of my real job.
Yeah. Resisting the silence is fighting internally now.
They're unemployed. No one has a real job there.
Yeah.
God,
that's all we have. Whatever.
Bring it.
Yeah, talk about getting a job, right?
I know.
They say bad publicity is better than no publicity.
Not intimidation. What is the word?
Imitation.
Imitation is the best form of flattery.
Yep.
Yeah.
Going with it.
Oh, shit. Yeah. Paul's going to be like Napoleon Dynamite riding the horse across the field.
That's awesome.
Lucky.
That's awesome. I love that show.
The white shirt on.
All right.
All right. We have to
silly
now. I know.
Come on. That's fantastic.
All right. We'll see you tomorrow. If not, we'll see you on.
We'll see most tomorrow. I'll be making some posts, but Dana and Tracy will be starting Friday. We'll be making all the posts while I'm gone.
Yeah.
And, listen, I give it up for these two too. Like, I do all the posting, so sometimes my face gets plastered all over the place. But the truth of the matter is, without the three of us, none of this would happen. If Tracy drops off, we're not doing this. If Dana drops off, it just doesn't happen. The three of us working together is what's getting this done for us. So nobody's more important than anybody else. The same as we're not important as anybody in that chat. We say it all the time. Yep. Say it all the time. I see Neil in the chat. I can't go to a standout without seeing Neil.
I know. I love it.
You know?
Neil's my boy.
Christy Mello, she's everywhere. Yeah. People, so we just happened to brainstorm and come up with a channel just to get this going. And so you guys can come here and find out what we're doing next week. And here you are. And up in Stoneham, one woman came to the Stoneham standout because she saw it on this channel. She's not on Facebook. She's not on Twitter. She's found our channel. She saw it and she showed up at the Stoneham standout.
That's cool.
So we could stop tomorrow and we've done our job.
Oh. We won't. We've got no quit.
Nope.
All right. Well, we'll see you guys and talk tomorrow. It could be you never know. We might show up live tomorrow night.
Yeah, we'll see.
Yeah.
We'll see how it goes. But yeah. I got a feeling everyone will be live tomorrow night.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah. Yeah, it's gonna be chaotic.
It is.
Hopefully a good chaos.
Yeah.
Hopefully.
Yeah, I like that. Don't forget on your way out, hit that like button, please. We never say that enough.
I never think about it. I'm just like,
We got to blame on Maude, Michelle.
Yeah, come on, Michelle. Jeez.
No,
just kidding. We love you. You know that.
Thank you, Michelle.
She does all a great job.
Yes, she does.
Good night, everybody. All right.
Good night, everyone.
May the 4th be with you. Thank you.
Yeah. It's April.